So I was supposed to make this video 4 years ago. It's 2022. I'm basically going to talk about how I got diagnosed with major depressive disorder, anxiety, and schizophrenia. So I've had three different therapists in the past years, and my first therapist was, I used to tell her that I wanted to start a YouTube channel and I wanted to post about all the hardships I had. And she said, "That's a great idea, Molly." And she told me that I would really help some people, and I have helped no one. If you're going through the same, not the same things, I'm sure you can't, you're not going through all of the three worst mental disorders at the same time. But yeah, she was just like, go for it. And I was like, okay, Patricia. Of how everything happened from high school up. As you can imagine, high school wasn't the greatest for me. A lot of my friends didn't really know about some of the stuff that I was going through because I wasn't open about it. I don't even think I told my therapist about it. I kind of just told her I was really upset, and I never told her about any of this stuff. If she had known about it, maybe we would have actually come to a resolution. And I'm talking about it now. It's a little too late, of course, but we're gonna talk about it. So freshman year, first semester was I didn't have any problems. It was fine. Second semester is where everything went wrong. There was this girl in my chorus class. I had chorus class first semester and second semester. Of freshman year. I actually met my boyfriend first semester in chorus, and we weren't together then. We actually got together in sophomore year for me, junior year for him. But I met him, and he wasn't the nicest person to me. He was very moody, but that's irrelevant. That's not part of this. So second semester, chorus, there was this girl in my class. And she was cruel. Every single day, every morning, I would come in and she would say, "Molly, you're not pretty, you're not cute, you're not whatever." Tell me why I was so devastated to hear that every single morning. I didn't stand up for myself because honestly, I was a little bit scared of her. She didn't just say stuff, she actually hurt me physically. We had a xylophone in chorus class, of course, and the little sticks that she would hit me on the legs with them, and she would hit my knees, and I ended up having bruises from all that. And I never told anybody about that. Like, I don't even think I told my boyfriend about that. So yeah. Obviously, I didn't tell anybody. I didn't tell my therapist. I didn't tell my family. It was just something I thought was normal. I mean, I know it wasn't like people weren't going to school and getting beat up by xylophone tongs. So I would get beat by xylophone tongs every single day. And that was my life. Also, if it weren't bad enough, she punched me in the face. She punched me in the face. And now my jaw kind of like cracks. I don't know how to describe it. It's like, it wasn't like that before, believe it or not. When she punched me, the teacher was not in the room, so I got no help. Also, there was a senior guy, and he was actually the scarecrow in the play, and I was Dorothy. And he, while we were rehearsing in chorus class in the morning, he dragged me across the floor by my hair, and the teacher was there for that one. And guess who didn't help me? She also didn't have kids at the time, She has a kid now. I'm not mad anymore, believe it or not, but I actually told my mom about that one, and I think she probably scared the teacher. She put the fear of God in her, as mom would say, as mom told me. And I think she told her that, like, how about I drag you across the floor by your hair? The teacher still has her job, by the way. But it was pretty hardcore for me. But yeah, she was in there for that class when I got dragged across the floor by my hair, and she did not help me one bit. Pretty sure she actually laughed, like, with the rest of the class. Also, I had this best friend. He was my best friend. And him and this girl, the girl was not my best friend. She actually bothered me every single day about my GPA being above hers. And yeah, but they both had lunch with me, and they said, I was at the top of the GPA list. I was at the top of our class. But they said that once they took the class that I was in at the moment, that their GPA would go above mine. Tell me why that tell me why that hurt my heart so much. I had the thinnest skin in high school. Like, everything was so abrasive. Is that the word? I don't know. But I took it to heart, and it was actually one of the reasons why I left high school, because I went through that kind of talk every single day. I mean, like, or at least most days. And it really hurt my feelings that my best friend would say something like that. Yeah. And he actually, like, when I left school, he messaged me on Snapchat. He did all this stuff, and I never answered him once. He probably wondered why I was so not nonchalant, why I didn't respond and all this stuff. It's because I was pissed. He still doesn't know that I'm sure he knows that he's not my favorite person anymore, but, like, I'm not mad anymore. I just, like, if he were to talk to me again, I'm sure I would be more friendly, because he was my best friend. He was so fun to talk to. But yeah, there was also this girl in my class. Her mom was a teacher, and she saw the GPA list. She saw that I was at the top, and of course she told everybody. So the kids in my class, that girl that I talked about with my best friend, she would ask the teachers in front of me, why is Molly at the top? Why am I not above her? All this stuff. And one of the teachers laughed, and she said, I don't know. And I was like, why are you encouraging this behavior? Why are you being an instigator, pretty much? Like, as I said, I was very emotional. I was it hurt my feelings really bad. I'm sorry. So I eventually left high school after sophomore year. And honestly, I wish I hadn't left, not because I would have been the valedictorian. I don't really care about that. Just because I learned a lot better in person. I found out that online school was not for me. I did it anyway, but I basically didn't learn anything that I didn't know. Then came community college. At the end of that semester in 2018, I was diagnosed with psychosis and schizophrenia and encephalitis. Encephalitis, I believe, is like inflammation of the brain. So all this stuff has been happening to my brain. I don't know what's going on up there. I had encephalitis. They think that that's what caused my psychosis. And I think they think that it might have caused my schizophrenia too. But personally, I think that I might have had schizophrenia or symptoms of it in high school. Cause I was a little bit manic, nothing that was obvious, but, yeah. I mean, I don't know. When I had psychosis, I had hallucinations and I was delusional, typical symptoms of psychosis. Actually some examples of, my delusions were, I thought that, I could speak, I mean, I thought that I could speak to people's dead loved ones. Unfortunately, I was not a medium. I also thought that our cat was dying. I thought that I could feel him dying. That cat is still alive today. I also thought that I was pregnant and that I was having continuous miscarriages, as if you could have continuous miscarriages in a day. I thought that the police could hear me through my headphones. Like, I thought they were spying on me. Which, I mean, maybe they are, maybe they were. But I cannot confirm that for certain. I thought that people could read my mind. I thought that I didn't have to explain myself because they knew what I was thinking. I didn't think I was crazy. I thought that other people were wrong and crazy and sociopathic, is that a word? I don't know. But I didn't think I was the one. Like, sorry, Patricia. I'm going crazy. I acted out a ton. I actually got sent to a psych ward for 3.5 months. And so yeah, like they took everything away from me. And I'm actually kind of glad that they took my phone from me, because if they hadn't, I would have continuously started posting ridiculous Snapchats and texted people and called people like I had been doing. Thank God they took it away from me. I mean, I had already created a lot of damage when I was in the early stages of it and I wasn't like getting help, but I lost a lot of friends and you know, like my actual friends know like what happened and they are sympathetic and they are still my friend and whatnot. But like people random, like people that I met in freshman year of college, like that semester that I was diagnosed, they really weren't close, except for one, Maggie. So they gave me ECT to break the psychosis, which is electroconvulsive therapy. And that actually worked, which is pretty great. They also put me on an antipsychotic. They tested a bunch of them on me. None of them worked except for clozapine. And clozapine is pretty rare for people to be on. It actually, I'm pretty sure it lowers your white blood cell count and can give you leukemia. Therefore, you have to go to the get your blood work done once a month, which I do. And I'm also on an injection of Abilify every month. I've tried to film this video so many times. And every time I filmed it, like back then, I would cry. I actually tried to film this yesterday, and I did film it yesterday. And I was so critical of my performance, like it's a play. I was critical of my mood, and not my mood, my monotone voice. And it actually wasn't as bad as it is right now. So I guess we'll see which one I end up posting. The ECT. The electroconvulsive therapy has wrecked my brain. Not like terrible, but when I see a paragraph or something like that, or somebody makes a post and it's a long post, I'd love to read it, but if it's not highlighted or in bold print, it takes me forever to read it because my mind like stutters over the words and it irritates the heck out of me. Because I mean, I just like to be able to read like a span of words together. I'm not the same person that I was before. I'm no scholar. Yeah, I'd love to go back, but I just haven't gotten the personal push to go back yet. I finally made the video. Also, there's this quote that I saw the other day that made me think of how I feel about high school now. And it goes, "Forgiveness is taking the knife out of your own back and not using it to hurt anyone else, no matter how they hurt you." Which is probably the best explanation I could give about how I feel. I'm just pretty much beyond it. Yeah. All the people who hurt me, physically, mentally, whatever, I don't care anymore. But now I kind of just want to move on.